Hello and welcome to BharatShakti.in. I am Nitin Gokhale, and with me today is the chairman of Defence Research and Development Organisation, Dr. Satish Reddy. And we are going to talk to him about various plans and development programs that the DRDO has for the Indian Armed Forces to strengthen the nation's defence. Dr. Reddy, thank you very much for your time. DRDO is an organization which is at the forefront of Make in India in defense, and also, of course, doing a lot of research for India's defense and, of course, defense capabilities to be built. Just recently, I think the Prime Minister went and spoke to young scientists at Bangalore, and he also dedicated to the nation, I think, if I remember correctly, young scientist laboratories. Can you tell us a little bit about what that project is?
See, Prime Minister had actually directed us in 2014 that why not you have 5 young scientist laboratories where everyone there is below 35 years old.
Okay.
So, I worked on it and then created 5 young scientist laboratories. Generally, most of them are connected to the academic institutes, and in 5 places, Bombay, Chennai, Hyderabad, Bangalore and Calcutta, on in 5 subjects, artificial intelligence, quantum computing, cognitive technologies and advanced materials, smart materials, and asymmetric technologies.
Oh, so this is all futuristic?
Futuristic technologies. And all the scientists who are there in that laboratories are below 35 years old. And they have the same powers as any director in any other laboratory.
Really?
So, everything is given to them, same powers. And so, they will be working on these technologies. And they are well connected to academic institutes like, let's say, quantum computing is in IIT Mumbai. The cognitive technologies is in IIT Chennai. And the asymmetric technologies is in IIT Kharagpur, Kolkata campus. So, likewise, they are well connected to the academic institutes also. So, they work on the futuristic technologies. And Prime Minister was there in Bangalore and dedicated these 5 labs to the nation. He interacted with all the scientists and also said that you can create more as these laboratories are getting matured also.
Right.
So, there is a good experiment to work on the futuristic technologies, encouraging the youngsters of the country.
So, clearly DRDO is working on not just futuristic technology, but a lot of very important technologies for Indian Armed Forces. And we are about to complete 1 year, maybe the next month in March, when you conducted the anti-satellite test last year. What has been your experience in doing that, and what ability it brings to the nation?
Firstly, the scientists have come up to the expectations. Honorable Prime Minister has given us 2 years time to do such a experiment, and it's not a easy task. It's such a complex mission, completely building a missile in 2 years time, design, development and whatnot and everything, launching the satellite, and people have worked day and night for the last 2 years, and 27th March last year the experiment was done. It's a very complex and very critical mission. See, you are having a satellite in the low Earth orbit at about 300 kilometers, at about 7.8 kilometers per second velocity. The interceptor missile, you have to launch it with precision, time-wise, and then it has to travel with that to that 300 kilometers, and it is going close to about 3 kilometers per second. And so, relative velocity between the two is about 11 kilometers per second, and there is no explosive or anything. You have to go and directly hit it, and the satellite is just 1.2 meters by 1.1 meter is the size of it. And then you hit it close to about 6 centimeters from the geometric center.
So, it's a very precise.
Very precise operation. So, this has given the boost to the morale of the scientists that we can take up such complex missions, and we will be able to do such complex missions. World has recognized India that yes, it has the capabilities to do that.
Sure.
This actually gives a lot to the country. First thing is, before the international community, you have become a technological power. Okay, this is number one. Number two, in the space, you have proven your technologies, and then it becomes a good deterrence. Mm-hmm. Third, the ballistic missile defense program, you are able to engage the targets at about 300 kilometers, and that gives the capability for engaging ballistic missiles, which are even by 5,000 kilometers and longer range also. So this has given multiple advantages and benefits to the country. And of course, morale boost to the scientists.
Of course.
This Honorable Prime Minister himself coming and announcing to the nation, that's a DRDO was one of the very, very happy occasions.
That's true. But DRDO has done well. I mean, if you look back, and you were also DG at one time of the missiles and strategic systems, that particular segment has particularly done well over the past 5 years or so. So, give us a sense of where we are as far as missiles testing and missile inductions are concerned in all the three armed forces.
Firstly, as far as the missile technologies are concerned, we are self-sufficient, mm-hmm. and we can build any missile what armed forces look for. Particularly in the last 1 year, lot of systems have been, developments have been completed, development trials have been completed. Look at today, the anti-tank missile NAG, it has gone through the user trials.
Right.
In the summer, in the deserts, we have successfully proven the NAG with a high precision and all that. Second, the air-to-air missile Astra, it has gone through the complete developmental trials. A very good missile for the country, which has a range of about 100 kilometers, and it is able to engage the target at that range, launched from Su-30 aircraft. Then we have the QRSAM, quick reaction service-to-air missile also. That is also, reaction time is very less, and that also development trials have been completed. Completely everything is indigenous in that system, whatever have been made in all these systems. Mm-hmm. And also the guided Pinaka, okay. that's also another missile what mm-hmm. has been done. That is also very quickly, it in a short period of about 3 years, we have completely yeah. development has been done, development trials have been completed. Mm-hmm. Now we are in many things, we are in advanced stage of development, like helicopter launched Helena anti-tank missile, that's mm-hmm. also in advanced stage of development. We have man-portable ATGM anti-tank right. missile, that's also in an advanced mm-hmm. stage of development. Mm-hmm. Lots of development trials have been completed.
Sure.
So likewise, many systems have been gone through the trials and doing extremely well in the missiles.
Right. You're working closely with the armed forces on what their requirements are. Are they also telling you that this is what the future requirements are? How does it work?
These are all based on the PSQRs from the armed forces. We have complete synergy with the armed forces,
right.
and we have in fact monitoring teams present in the projects also at various locations where their laboratories are there.
Yeah.
They are a part and parcel of it, and we have quarterly interaction meetings also,
sure.
wherein we review and take decisions based on whatever requirements are there. And,
sure.
and not only the missiles, a lot of other areas also.
Yeah,
are
but
done
before
well.
We go to other areas, just two questions. One on, of course, the Agni, which is now Agni 5, which is fully, I think, developed and already ready. And about the submarine launch missile, where are we on that program?
The Agni 5, as you know, that the development trials have been completed and the induction process is on.
Okay.
And I wouldn't be able to answer your question on the submarines, as it is
it's a classified
programs.
Okay.
And we are, as I said, in any of the areas, we mm-hmm. are having the capabilities to develop any type of a missile, the complete technologies, whether it is propulsion technology, avionics, navigation control, mm-hmm. and the design capability we have in the country today. Any missile, any type of a requirement armed forces give, we are sure that we will be able to develop such a missile in a very short span of time. We definitely stand as one of the very few nations who have such capabilities.
Right.
See, look at BMD today, Ballistic Missile Defense Program, what we have done, very successful program. We are one of the 4 or 5 nations in the world who have such a successful programs running and all that.
True.
And even the long-range missiles also, when you look at it, we are one of the
few
nations in the world who have such things.
True.
And we don't depend on anything today from outside, so that's we'll right. be able to develop anything.
But like you said, it's not only missiles. You've also now gone into different segments.
We are very strong now in radars. Right. We are very strong in sonars.
Mm-hmm.
Sonars, we are developing one of the best systems here in the country.
Mm-hmm.
And any type of a radar, we will be able to develop. The right. industry is also geared up today. Industry is able to come up to our requirements today. We are very good in EW systems, electronic warfare systems. We are good in torpedoes. We have multiple torpedoes. Our Varunastra is already getting inducted. Many other torpedoes we are developing. And we also have developed guns.
Mm.
This is the world's longest range gun,
mm-hmm.
ATAX, has right. been developed by the country through two industries. And
right. This is the artillery gun.
Artillery gun, the 155mm gun.
Sure.
And that is also, trials are going through, and we had the successful development of trials. And that is one of the other good things what happened.
Yes.
And also, last year is very good for us. The final operational clearance of the LCA has come.
LCA has come finally.
Absolutely.
Yes, that's right.
And so that is getting through, and shortly the 83 numbers order should be placed.
Given to HAL.
HAL, yeah. And that production goes on. And you know that the LCA Navy has landed on Vikramaditya successfully and
absolutely.
Taken off. A number of trials are going on. So that is a very major milestone for us as far as the naval aircraft is concerned.
Absolutely true. In fact, that was one of the constant criticisms against the Indian systems or the Indian the DRDO or the scientists, that they have not been able to develop a light combat aircraft or a fighter aircraft. So that's a very important milestone you spoke about. But I also wanted to speak to you about the kind of ecosystem that you have developed in the country. You got a lot of private sector partners on almost every program. How does that work, the MSMEs and the larger players?
We have lots of industries working with us now today. More than about 1800 industries are working with us today, whether it's tier 3, tier 2, and some cases in tier 1 as industries in many programs. But the as an example, I'll give you the Akash case, where Akash BDL is producing the Akash missile. But still, more than 85% of the by value things come from private industry to BDL, and that's how the BDL could produce even more than 60 missiles a month. And so industry is working with us very closely,
mm-hmm.
and we have brought in lots of policies wherein industry can get benefited.
Sure.
One thing is, we have brought in a model called DCPP, development come production partner. Right. It becomes right in the beginning of the project.
So they do it jointly kind of develop
jointly it. Develop it, mm-hmm. and then they learn parallelly, and there is right. no separate TOT required, mm-hmm. whatnot. And then the technology transfers, what we are doing, we have made it zero technology transfer fee. And we have lots of patents with us, and all the patents we have made it open.
Right.
And we have made it public. Anybody can go through that patents and they can use it. And lots of our test facilities, we have made it open for the industry. They can use those test facilities. And if our product, they want to export it, we are going to handhold them. Lots of procedures have been brought in.
Mm-hmm.
And in fact, industry, if they are doing some technology development which is useful to
mm-hmm.
The country and to the armed forces, we are giving funding also called technology development funding.
Fund.
Any
that's right.
So many schemes we are bringing in, lot more to where to come also to promote startups also.
Mm.
So industry ecosystem we are trying to build,
exactly.
wherein industry can come up with the design development capabilities also within the
sure.
country.
So there's a lot of energy and a lot of revival, I would say, in terms of the both the spirit and the work of the DRDO. Are you faced with a situation where you know, your scientists that you take in, the number of people, the scientists especially, are there enough? Is there enough talent? I wanted to ask you in India, and are they sort of being nurtured by DRDO? How are you working on that?
See, a lot of people are interested in joining DRDO, and a lot of talent is joining DRDO. In fact, a couple of missions what we have worked now, youngsters have contributed a lot.
Mm-hmm.
The BMD program particularly, the contribution of young scientists is immense. We only need a lot more manpower, and looking towards that, and hopefully we should be able to get a good number of manpower.
Right.
And also we are finding various mechanisms how to take the youngsters and try to work. like people who are registered for PhD, we want to take them to the laboratories and make work on our problems. We are trying to take lots of people as junior research fellows and senior research fellows and all that. We are also trying to hire people, good talent, for a limited period of 3 years and 4 years and try to utilize them. So we are finding various mechanisms how to engage youngsters. As we are taking up lots of programs today, we have LCA Mark II, we have taken up AMCA and many other programs we are taking up. With these programs being taken up, we need to have young talent. Any organization has to be vibrant, they need to be always having a continuous inflow of youngsters.
That's
and
right.
So definitely we are also looking for that.
Yeah, exactly. What about exports? I mean, are people or collaboration with other countries in terms of scientific research or even development?
Both are happening. One is the collaborations with various countries. We have research collaborations with many countries. Lots of interest is being shown by those countries, and we are working in many areas with various countries.
Right.
And also even exports also, a lot of interest is shown by many countries. And we are made a catalog of various products what we can export also. It is being circulated and there are lots of inquiries are coming. And I am hopeful that in the coming years, we should be able to export a lot also to various nations.
That's right.
And also with collaborations, work on the futuristic technologies, advanced technologies, what is required for
That's
the nation.
That's very good to know. So clearly, a lot of energy, as I mentioned, and as a lot of you know, plans in for the future. So I wish you all the best for what you are doing. And I think the nation deserves what you are doing.
Thank you.